Hello and welcome to this session on correlation. Today we are going to learn what correlation is, why do we need correlation, and how do we use regular expression extractor in JMeter for correlation. Let us begin. Correlation is a process whereby we fetch a value from the response of a step and then we refer this value into the request of any subsequent step. And this happens at runtime, therefore we also call it dynamic referencing. Let us understand this. Correlation is essentially a two-step process whereby in the first step we extract the dynamic value from the response of a step and then we refer this extracted value into the request of a subsequent step. Let us now understand why do we need it. Let us take an example. We have our test plan, and in our test plan we have multiple steps and every step has a request and a response. Let us suppose we have a web application test plan and our very first step is login step, and then we have some more steps and then we have a logout step. Now in most of the web applications, on login we get a session ID and then we have to pass this session ID into all the subsequent requests so that a valid session is maintained. Now this session ID is generated dynamically and every time you will get a new session ID, so you cannot store it in a static way and refer it in the subsequent steps. It has to be extracted during runtime and then it has to be given as a reference to other steps. So homepage should get a session ID from the login step and then other pages as well. So this is why we need this dynamic referencing or correlation. Let us understand how do we use regular expression extractor for correlation in JMeter. Step one is we have to create a test plan. So let us go to our JMeter and I am going to create a thread group first. Inside this thread group, I'm going to add a sampler. Let me add a HTTP request sampler and here we will add any website. So let me go to this particular site called lifecharger.org. I will copy this and let me give it here. We of course do not need HTTP here and let us save this. And also let me add a listener to see the results. I am adding a view results tree listener and let me just run this to validate. And yes, we are getting a successful response here and this is our request and this is our response data. Now I need to apply regular expression extractor on this response so that we can fetch some values. So let us go to our request and I'm going to right click here, go to add, go to post processors, and here you will find regular expression extractor. Click here and it is added as a child of this request and now we can add our regular expression. Let us understand this particular element. You can see this is the window for regular expression extractor. And you have the options where you can apply this particular expression and then you also have the field you want to apply to body or to response header, request headers and so on. Let us select body. And now we have these fields which are very important. We have reference name. You can give any reference name. I am giving it a name like reference value. And then you have to give a regular expression which will extract the values, a template name, the match number and default value. Okay, so let us go to step 2 and step 2 says we have to add a regular expression extractor step from where response values needs to be extracted, which we have already added, and then we have to refer the extracted value. So before we do that we have to add the regular expression here. So to understand what does this mean is let us go to some particular online regex tester, we can go to this particular site called recexr.com, and this is a very good site where you can actually create and test your regular expressions. And before we go into that, let me just explain. Regular expressions are the expressions created with the help of meta characters, which are used to extract or fetch some matching values in the text. Let us take an example. I have a text called, let me write anything here. This is a automation test lab. Okay, now this is the area where I can write any regular expression. I can simply write the entire word here, and you can see it is matching this particular text here. I can say is space automation test. Now it is matching this entire phrase here, and you can see it is showing us the match. Now if I put this particular thing inside bracket, the word automation, it is still matching the entire text, but you can see it has created groups now, and whatever was there within the bracket is being given to a particular group, which is group 1. So similarly, I can write any regular expression here. Now suppose I write this is JMeter test lab. Now it is not matching this particular text because we have automation written here hard-coded. So instead of this, we can also write dot star question mark. This means it should match anything, and then it should stop when it gets the match. So now you can see it is matching this text as well and this line as well, and JMeter is coming as a in the group. Okay, so similarly, we can create a regular expression extractor for our response, which is here. So let me copy this. I have just copied the response of our request from JMeter inside this particular website, and I want to create a regular expression now. So I can create something like, I know that I want to extract out the links from this response. So let me see what are the links it is matching. So yes, you can see I'm just writing this particular expression here that it should match this text, and then whatever is after this, I'm saying dot star question mark, so it will match everything after this, and question mark it will stop once it finds the match, and then the link ends here. So I'm adding this particular text here, and now you can see it has found 44 matches. Okay, and you can go and you can see this is the group. So now I can use this particular regular expression and put it here in the field regular expression. Now the template, I am saying $1. So this is the count of the group. As of now, we have put a single expression inside the brackets, which is there will be only a single group. So I am saying $1. I can also say $2, $3, and so on if I have multiple groups of matching in regular expression. As of now, I have just one, so I'm keeping $1. Now here is the match number. So this regular expression can match multiple values inside the text. So I'm saying I just want the match number 4. Okay, if you want to put any default value, if it does not find any match, you can put it here. As of now, I am leaving it blank. And now what I'm going to do is I have to refer this particular expression or the outcome of this expression into some subsequent step. So let me add another sampler, which is going to be HTTP request. Let me put it here and let me say it, this is HTTP link. And now what I'm going to do here is I'm not going to give any URL, but I will extract it from here and give the result of this extraction. So what I'm going to do is I will say dollar and then curly braces, and then I will put the name of my regular expression field. So this is what it should get, what it has referenced, and it should put it here. So this is how we refer the extracted value. And now let me clear the results and let me run it again. So the very first step passed, and you can see the second step, which is the HTTP link, this again passed. And if you see the request, it has actually taken this particular URL out of the regular expression. You can see I have not mentioned any URL here. I have just mentioned the outcome of the regular expression extractor, which is this particular expression. And this expression has worked on the response of the first request, and it has fetched the link, which is this link, and used as the second step. So this is how we can use regular expression extractor and refer the values in the subsequent step. Step 4 is of course run and validate, which we have already done. And then you can also use a regexp tester. Let me show you. If you go to your view results tree listener, you can see this drop down. Here you will find this regexp extractor. Okay, so you can go here, and what it gives you is, it gives you this particular field where you can add your regular expression, and it will work on the response of that particular step, and it will show you the matches. So let us do one thing. Let me add the same regular expression that we used here. Okay, let me just add it here, and let me click on test, and you can see it has matched 44, which is true, because here also we got 44 matches, and it is showing us all the matches, and we can create our regular expression using this view results tree listener. So this is how we can make use of this handy option in view results tree. So this is how you can use regular expression extractor. I hope the concept of correlation is very clear to you now, and we know how do we use regular expression extractor in JMeter for correlation. I will meet you in the next session. Thanks for watching.